Hey guys, in this video, I just wanted to do a short demonstration on how to find differentially expressed genes from single-cell RNA sequencing data. So I'm going to start with a gene expression matrix and then end with a list of differentially expressed genes and their respective p-values. And this is from single-cell RNA sequencing data. I just found a public data set online of human cells, and I will put this script in the description box below, but let me go ahead and go over it now. So I'm going to first load in a gene expression matrix, and this is going to be formatted as genes by cell. So each row is going to be a gene, and then each column is going to be a cell or a sample. And we see that that's the case when I load in the data frame. So the individual cells of the gene expression matrix are counts. And the next couple of lines of code are just going to filter the gene expression matrix. So the majority of this code is actually just filtering, and it's going to depend on every lab is going to filter the data differently. But for me, I'm going to remove genes that are found in fewer than 30 samples, and that was done in these two lines of code. Then I'm going to save the gene expression matrix as a scran object. So I'm going to load in the package scran and then save the gene expression matrix as a scran object. I'm going to do that in order to do some pre-processing in scran. So I'm going to calculate clusters, compute sum factors, and normalize the data all in scran. And I'm going to do that in the next couple lines of code. After normalizing the data, I'm then going to save the scran object as a Seurat object, because in Seurat is where we're going to actually calculate the differentially expressed genes. So I'm going to load in the Seurat package and then save the scran object as a Seurat object. And this is the step where I perform a log transformation on the data as well. So on the counts, I'm taking the counts plus one and then doing a log transform and then saving that as the gene expression matrix and then creating a Seurat object from that gene expression matrix. Once I've done that, I'm going to run one final line of code for pre-processing, which is scale data. So this will regress out batch effects. And it's basically the final pre-processing step before we actually calculate differentially expressed genes from our gene expression matrix. And so the one line of code to find differentially expressed genes in Seurat is find all markers. And this line of code has a couple optional parameters. So basically, you just pass in a Seurat object that has your gene expression filtered matrix. And then I also added two optional filters. So I'm filtering the log fold change to be a minimum threshold of 0.25, and then a minimum percentage of belonging to either group as 25% as well. And then these lines of code, after I find my list of differentially expressed genes, I want to save that as a comma separated value file. So this is just going to, if the list is very long, I just ran this line of code to make sure that it prints the entire list. And then I'm going to actually run the line of code that finds my differentially expressed genes. And this takes a minute to run. So that code took about a minute to run, and then once it's done, we have our final list of differentially expressed genes. So the result is basically this data frame, and it has all the list of differentially expressed genes. It has their respective p-values, the average log fold change, the percentage in the two populations, a Bonferroni corrected p-value, and also if you did clustering, it will tell you which cluster it belongs to as well. So this is the list of all the significant differentially expressed genes, and the final line of code just outputs that list as a CSV file. And that's all I wanted to show in this video.